Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for.
Tell me, do you want to go? Where it's covered in all the colored lights. Where the runaways are run of the night. Impossible comes true. It's taking over you.
This is the greatest show.
We light it up, we won't come down.
And the sun can't stop us now.
Watching it come true. It's taking over you.
This is the greatest show.
Hey everyone, this is the last episode before Christmas break.
I hope everyone has had a great week this week.
There's a new question of the week.
Let's go over to Dale to see what it is.
Oh, it's y'all again. Well, anyways, hey y'all, Dale here. And this week's question is, can you name all the reindeer? Peace!
Dancer and Prancer and Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen and Rudolph.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen and Rudolph.
Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen, and Rudolph.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen, and Rudolph.
Brady has a new game show this week.
Let's get to it.
Hello, everyone. I am Brady with this week's game show. So for this week's game show, we're having a Christmas game show because of the event of Christmas coming up. So, as you can see here, we have a Santa word search, and our five contestants here will need to look at these word searches and find as many words as they can. Whoever gets it done first wins. So, I think we should get started. Congratulations to Johnson for winning our competition. He got 10 out of 12 and he will get 25 dog tags. Back to you, anchors.
Summer and Jackson have a new classroom segment this week.
This week's segment is related arts.
Hey guys, it's Christmas time. The Helping Hands Club has decided to make quilts for the Clinton County Nursing and Rehabilitation Center. I have two of the boys that has been working with the Helping Hands, and we decided to display what we have been working on. Our quilts go to the nursing home on Tuesday afternoon and give to the residents. Balen, tell them about how you, some experiences that you've had quilting or making quilts.
Well, we had to like. We had to like sew two together, and then like we would have like fold them and like sew them again, and like make like this four tag, and then we had to like tack it, put the squares together. Here they are.
And Brady, what did you learn from quilting?
Well, first of all, this class has taught me how to sew. Before I joined this class, I had no idea how to sew, or I didn't know anything about it. But I went to the class a couple times, and then it just moved to the point where I came every day, and I learned how to sew really greatly. So now we make quilts like this even faster than we did before, and we're even learning how to make quilts by ourselves so we can keep them.
What we're trying to do is start a pilot program for that we do an outreach program to the nursing homes that are around us and make quilts for the residents at the nursing homes. Hopefully next year that we can reach out to another nursing home and make quilts for them. This year we have made 51 quilts. You'll notice that behind me we have them displayed, and also in the boxes in front of us that we didn't have room to display them. We're holding up three of them that we have also made.
Thank you. Hey, y'all. I'm here with Derek and Mark from the band to talk about the Christmas concert that happened last Sunday. So, how do you think the Christmas concert went?
I think it went well.
And do you think everyone liked it?
Yes.
What instruments do you play?
I play French horn.
I play tuba.
Thank you, guys.
My bones, it goes electric wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home, we're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, I feel that hot blood in my body.
Hi, my name is Aisha Sutton and I'm with Addison Weston and Noah McCutcheon from the sixth grade. What have you guys been doing over these past weeks?
We've been playing pickleball.
Can you explain what this game is?
So, we just get badminton nets, and we lower them, and, like, we get paddles, and, like, we hit it. I don't know. Yeah.
In conclusion, that is all we have for today.
A big noise playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing
we will rock you, we will.
Lately at Miss Kim's we have been reading plays and learning to be enthusiastic and very loud.
Is it a lot of fun?
Yeah, it's really fun. I enjoy it a lot.
There's an outdoor segment this week. Let's go over to Lucas and Owen to see what it is.
Hey y'all, welcome back to the outdoor segment. Let's head over to the tip of the week.
Hey guys, we're here with Miss Kathy for the tip of the week.
All right. When fishing for smallmouth bass on Del Hollow Lake, I like float and fly. That's really good. And also, jigs are really good.
There's many birthdays this week. Let's see who they are with Dell.
Hey y'all, they're here, and this week's birthdays are Emily Pittman, Gavin Mohorn, Stale Burchett, Dawson Denny, Jeremy Harrison, Coyle Chamberlain, Miss Carol, and Mr. Tyler Kennedy. Happy birthday, guys!
Brady has an infant fiasco segment this week.
Let's see the contestant he picked.
Hello everyone, I am Brady and this is Caleb for this episode of Food Fiasco. So basically how this works, if you don't know already, is that Miss Presley is going to be having some disgusting treats and me and Caleb is going to try them and see if we can guess what it is. That's basically it. Trying to throw up like I did last week. So I believe we should get started.
And my fault. Open wide.
I hate this. Where's the trash can? Is it nearby?
Yes.
It's right there.
Oh, sorry, Brady. I stabbed you.
Oh, it's not bad.
I'm getting wings.
Yeah, it's something like that. Good. Good as what I've eaten. I'm pretty sure I've eaten this before.
Why'd you make that face then?
What do you think about it?
I've never ate it whole, though.
You like it, Caleb?
Like in Chicago. It's like baby wings, like you said.
Do you like it?
I feel like I'm cooking or something.
You okay?
It was pretty good. Except for her putting the whole thing in my mouth. I'm pretty sure it was pretty good. What is it?
It is little beef sticks. It's baby food. It's, turkey sticks.
It's turkey sticks.
Little turkey sticks. You like them? You want more?
They taste like, no, but they taste like beanie weenies a bit.
Yeah.
Like candy.
You want to take a drink? Wash it down? All right, ready for number two? Ready?
Oh, gosh. I'm sorry, Brady. I keep stabbing you.
That's tomato soup.
Yeah, it is. It kind of tastes like the sauce from like SpaghettiOs or something. SpaghettiOs sauce, I believe. Yep.
It is tomato sauce.
Yes. The best of kind. Except
all right.
It's in the ketchup.
You ever had a donut?
What are you laughing at?
Hit me with it.
Your face is...
Open!
Open!
Mmm. Oh, yeah. Mmm.
You have to wait 20 seconds to take a drink.
That's really spicy.
Jalapenos.
Yep, it's jalapenos.
I don't think that was 20 seconds. Have you ever tried to eat a whole, like,
how you feeling?
Jalapeno by itself.
No. I don't like spicy stuff. Do you want another bite?
No. Mm-hmm. I think you
know. Oh, there is a number four. I forgot.
No.
There's a number four.
I swear if it's something hot, I'm going to...
Well, I can't get rid of the spicy, so...
Well, maybe this one will cleanse your palate.
I need milk.
Is it a breath mint?
It's not hot at all. I actually eat this for supper every night.
Yeah, this one's pretty good.
Okay.
Open your mouth.
Is it a breath mint?
This one will get rid of the taste.
Okay.
It's more jalapeno.
No.
That bite wasn't as spicy as the first one.
I think your taste buds are already just fried.
Yeah, probably.
Would you like some more tomato sauce? It'll help it cool.
That might actually help, yeah.
Open.
Oh, yes, that tastes like a whole hearty tomato.
I think Caleb's.
You can take your blindfolds off now.
You want another bite?
A bit more hopeful after this one. Last time I felt all depressed. Alright, well, that has been it for this episode. This one was not as bad as last episode. I have to admit the jalapenos got me the best of me and Caleb. Especially after a little prank that Miss Presley tried to pull off a little sneaky.
Yeah.
Give us the second day jalapenos. I can't feel my tongue at all now, but, first day was kind of good, and this was a good episode, so, thank you for tuning in to this episode, and, back to you, Anchor.
Cameron has a new sports update this week.
Take it away, Cameron.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the CCMS Sports Update. The boys basketball has been having games and practices lately. Let's go over to Jackson and talk with one of the players.
I'm here with Caleb and Drew from the boys basketball team. When was your last game?
Thursday.
How do you think y'all will do?
Amazing.
What's your team's weaknesses and how do you think you can improve?
Layups.
Free throws.
I think we can improve by working on them every day. And, you know, just trying our hardest.
Good luck at your next game. Back to you all.
Softball has also been going on, too. Let's go over to Summer to talk with some of their players.
Hey, y'all. I'm here with Chloe and Holden to talk about softball. So, how has practice been going so far?
It's been going good.
And winter tryouts?
Sometime in February.
What is your goal of the season?
Win as many games as we can.
And... Do you think you can achieve that goal?
Yes.
Thank you.
Volleyball has just started up. Let's see how the season has been going.
Hey, y'all. I'm here with Nevaeh to talk about volleyball. So, how's the season been going so far?
Pretty good.
And do y'all have practice every day?
Yes.
What's your goal this season?
To be undefeated.
And how do you think you can improve?
by getting our service better.
That's it for this week's Sports Update. I'm Cameron. See you next week.
Hey, Dylan Brady.
What's the joke this week?
Hey, Brady, what's red and white, red and white, red and white, red and white?
I don't know. What is it?
Santa rolling down a hill.
Let's hear some fun facts about our teachers with Lucas and John.
Hey, we're here with Sarah for the fun fact.
When I was in college, I got to go and help with rebuilding homes in the lower Ninth Ward after Hurricane Katrina with Habitat for Humanity.
We're here with the fun fact with Mr. Duval.
I spent 31 years of fifth grade and never did pass.
We have a new deputy this week.
Let's go over to Lucas to see who it is.
Hey, y'all, we're here with Kent for the deputy of the week.
Hey, fifth grader, Brianna Shelley, again. Outstanding student, makes me proud to keep seeing all you young people that are doing such a great job. She's doing a lot for her classmates and her teachers, and I'm proud to make her deputy. She gets our regular awards, the Burger King ticket for a good student. Pretty cool, I like it. Free ice cream there. Sonic slushy, your flavor, your pick. Dairy Queen, thank you for the ice cream, appreciate it. McDonald's burger, food service, ice cream or chips, your choice, just tell them. From the sheriff this week, a little something different because it's Christmas time. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
And your 25 dog dollars, don't forget that. Merry Christmas, we'll see you after the holidays. And I'm going to be picking another deputy. Step up, do that extra. Determination, attitude, willingness, goals, success. You can do it. Go dog.
Summer has a record-breaking competition. Let's go see if our contestants can break it.
Hey guys, unfortunately this week we had semester exams, so there won't be a world record. But me and Ivy are going to do a challenge for you. We're going to see who can wrap Christmas present the neatest and the fastest.
What's the weather looking like?
Especially on Christmas.
Hello everyone, I am Brady with this special episode of The Weather. So, as you know, Christmas is coming back up, and if you haven't noticed already this week, it's been snowing some. Okay, so let's get on with the weather. For today, it's going to be partially cloudy with a 0% chance of rain, a high of 52 degrees and a low of 34 degrees. It's going to be a bit warmer than usual out there, so yeah, there's that. On Saturday, it's going to be partially cloudy with a 10% chance of rain, a high of 54 degrees and a low of 34 degrees. On Sunday, it's going to be partially cloudy with a 10% chance of rain, a high of 54 degrees, and a low of 37 degrees. So, we're going to do some coverage on Christmas Eve and Christmas as well. So, on Christmas Eve, it's going to be sunny with a 10% chance of rain, with a high of 59 degrees and a low of 37 degrees. On Christmas, it's going to be kind of warm, so unfortunately, there's going to be no Christmas snow. Yeah, I know. Sad, right, cry, boohoo. So it's going to be partially cloudy with a 10% chance of rain with a high of 61 degrees and a low of 41 degrees. So that's been it for this week's weather. Remember, folks, you don't have to be a weatherman to know which way the wind blows.
Okay, that's all we have for this week.
I'm Amira.
I'm Avi. Merry Christmas. See you in 2020.
That only happens once.
Oh, wait, we gotta wear costumes.
Bonjour! Okay.
This is hot.
A wee.
Bloopers. Put down the bloopers.
It is. I just got a close up of you saying that.
Bloopers.
Summer and Jackson having this.
I'm so fluffy. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.